Hi everyone, if you want to make stream processing a breeze and you work with Apache Kafka, check out the videos in the channel and remember to click on the thumbs up if you find it useful. So today we're going to be talking about how you can build, scale and manage end-to-end data pipelines with two of my favorite tools, Lenses.io and Splunk. All this, as you're about to see, is with zero coding, just some config and scaled through Kubernetes. The scenario I'm going to walk you through is taking a couple of Kafka streams of data coming from ships fitted with GPS tracking. We're going to wrangle the data, send it onto Splunk, and visualize it in a map in real time. So buckle in because we're gonna go quite fast here. So first let's check what data we have. We have a stream of GPS tracking sitting in this fast vessel topic here. If we take a deeper look inside and inspect the data, there's a few fields of interest, latitude and longitude, and then this MMSI field, which is a unique identifier for every ship. Now we also have another stream sitting in a ships topic. And this also has that MMSI field, as well as the name of the ship and the owner. Now we're going to want to create a new data pipeline and send that data onto Splunk. But first, there's a few things we want to do with the data. Firstly, since ships don't move that fast and we want to limit the data going into Splunk, we're going to aggregate the data into 20-second rolling windows. Secondly, we want to enrich the data with the name of the ship and not have that MSI field. Now all this, as you're about to see, is with no coding, just some SQL, you don't need to be a dev. Ultimately, your pipelines are just configuration, which makes it super easy to review, to manage, and of course, to port across different environments. So back in Lenses, we create our streams in the SQL processor section here. Notice I already have a processor running, but let's go ahead and create a new one. Give it a name. And then to save a bit of time, I'm just gonna paste in my statement here. But to break it down very quickly, we're going to auto-create that ship movement topic and populate it with a few fields from the first stream, as well as doing a join on that ship stream to get the name of the ship using the MMSI key, and finally grouping on a tumbling window and the name of the ship. Notice I have a runners field there that's going to allow me to scale up or scale down on Kubernetes. I'm just going to keep it to one for the time being. Let's go ahead and save that. Now that's created, I get a view of exactly how the data is being wrangled, those two streams, the join, and ultimately populating to that ship movement topic. And of course, I can also see it in the context of all my data pipelines in the topology view, which I've showed in a few other videos, if you go back to them. And to complete our data pipeline, we're going to send the data onto Splunk. So let's go ahead and configure a Kafka Connect connector, sync connector. And I'm just going to paste in my connection settings to Splunk. And if we jump into Splunk, we should instantly see some data for such last 15 minutes. There we go, nicely formatted JSON objects. Let's just reformat that search and save it in a map and add it to our dashboard. And there we go. Let's just make our dashboard a little bit more attractive by adding a time picker, also so we can see it in real time. There we go, live tracking of our ships, our data pipeline created end-to-end in just a few minutes. How easy was that? Hope that was useful. Another reminder to like the video. You can also follow us on LinkedIn and Twitter, details below. Thanks for watching and ciao for now.